श्रेयस को वांटेड जॉइंट प्रभु
ओके इज ही देयर प्रभु
नो प्रभु
ओके आई स्पोक टू हिम ही सेड ही विल जॉइन बट एनीवेज Hey Jaina Mataji, you wanted to follow after me. If the tune is okay with you, you can join. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
राम राम हरे हरे
राम राम हरे 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 कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण Krishna Krishna Hare Hare
you sing it completely Mataji mantra should be completely said so sorry Mataji can you mute once so don't mind
sure
thank you Mataji Sri Harsha Prabhu has come I thought I'll give this service to him so he just joined Sri Harsha Prabhu you are there
yes Prabhu ji Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna. Prabhu, can you follow after me this kirtan?
Yes, Prabhu. Sure, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare.
Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Rama Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya Radha Ramana Hari Gopala Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna Mahamantra ki.
जय
अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय शील प्रभुपाद की जय थैंक यू प्रभु जी आफ्टर लॉन्ग टाइम वी हैव योर एसोसिएशन थैंक यू प्रभु थैंक यू ज्योत्सना माता जी थैंक यू फॉर योर इनिशियल support for, to come for Kirtan. We will do it together some other time. Sorry, forgive me for stopping.
No, no problem. No, thank you. Don't say like that.
Thank you, Mataji. So, I have seen you for the first time, Mataji. Are you coming for the first time or are you?
I attended some sessions with Prabhuji, but usually I attend Sunday mentor class, Saturday okay. and Sunday, but today I'm not able to go to it. Okay. Probably it is cancelled today, so I thought I could join.
Okay, so it is our great fortune that you are here. Thank you, Mataji.
I hope, Prabhuji.
Thank you, Mataji.
Okay. Thank you, Prabhuji.
ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानान्दनशलाकया चक्षुरुर्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं पदान्तिकं वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरो वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सागरजातां सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादां सहगण सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं जय श्रीकृष्णचैतन्यप्रभुनित्यानन्द श्रीअद्वैत गदाधरा श्रीवसदी गौरभक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे Sriharsh Prabhu, please kindly take care of if there is any disturbance, please try to mute them. Okay? Thank you, Prabhu. Okay, thank you. So, it's my great fortune that I am able to discuss this holy text, Sri Bhagavad Gita. And so we are in chapter 2 now, and what we have discussed is that in the chapter 1, Arjuna was bewildered by the kind of situation he was in. Well, he couldn't make decisions in his life, whether to fight or not. And similarly, in our life also, we come to a crossroad in some unique occasions, and in general also, that we don't know what to do with ourselves. We don't know which way to go. We are in crossroads. And in a crucial kind of situation, what we need to do is what Bhagavad Gita is teaching, and Arjuna is becoming as an example to us what we should do ideally in that kind of a situation. So, and finally, he tried to address whatever situation he was in with his own knowledge, with his past experience, but nothing worked out. Finally, he has submitted himself to the Guru, to Lord Krishna, and he has given him the Guru Sthan. And till that time, Krishna never spoke. In our life also, unless until you come forward, Lord will not take one step. It's ideally, that is the situation most of us are. Because we came from the Lord's abode, and we are in this material world. So now when you make one step ahead, Krishna will make 10 steps, and he will try to see to it that you come back to home, back to Godhead. So that is what we are all in. But for that, what we have done or what we should do is that we should follow what Arjuna has been following. First, he has taken the shelter of the Guru. So we also are taking the shelter of the Guru of Srila Prabhupada, who has given this transcendental literature and who is guiding us through this ISKCON, through the process that is being laid out by the Yuga Dharma, the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra and the spiritual process, whatever is laid down. So that's one thing. First step we have seen is that Arjuna has taken the shelter of the Guru, and we also have to take the shelter of the Guru. So that, because a Guru's role is to remove darkness from our life. Ajnana Timirandasya. Ajnana Timirandasya means the ignorance that is there, which is compared with the darkness, will be removed by Guru's mercy only. And that is what Arjuna did, and we should also do. The second thing is that we also need the right kind of a knowledge, which is what Guru is going to give. That is what Krishna is trying to give in the second chapter. He started to tell that, hey, Arjuna, you are lamenting for the things which are not supposed to be lamenting upon. So he has given the knowledge of the real knowledge, or he has given him the real identity of who he is. And that's what he talked about the soul. He's not this material body, he's spirit soul. And so act accordingly. So the third thing that he has done after that is that he has given him the saying that there are two dharmas that you will be need to perform always. One is your, because you have this body, you have a conditional duty that you need to do because of the body, material dharma you have. So swadharma, material swadharma you have because you have this body, and you also need to perform your sanatana dharma because you are actually a spiritual entity. And being, since you also have a spiritual body and you're a spiritual entity, you have to do your sanatana dharma. So that is what he has been able to explain so far. Now, after this, Krishna is going to, Arjuna is asking one question. The question that Arjuna is asking is that, so yes, I understand that I need to do all this. I need to perform my dharma. And I also need to take care of two dharmas, your material dharma and also a spiritual dharma. But what is the characteristic of a person, or what is that this person, when he performs these two duties very perfectly, what will he achieve? That is what Arjuna has posed a question. And for that, Krishna is going to answer. And that is the, these are the things that we'll be discussing today. So anybody has any doubt before we really dig deeper into the subject matter for today? Any doubts, any one doubt that you have, please raise. We'll address that and then go to the whatever discussion we wanted to do today. Any doubts, anybody? Either on chat you can put or raise your hand. Anything is fine. Okay, Ravi Prabhu has got a doubt. So go ahead, Prabhu.
All the way from his birth till that war, Prabhu, battle, till he reached Kurukshetra, and till the time he was standing in the front row from Pandavas, he was all right. Why suddenly he has gone into that kind of state that no, all these people are my relatives, friends and all that?
Yeah. So, very good question, Prabhu. So, see, I'll give you an example. Suppose there is a boy who prepared for his engineering entrance or a medical entrance. And for last 2 years, he's been working so hard day and night, putting a lot of effort. And finally, when he came on the exam day, he's saying that whether I should write the exam or not. So what will you tell about that kind of a person? So the Arjuna's situation was also that. See, for a warrior, his examination is the battlefield. So that is what they'll do, all their preparation for the battlefield only. See, Arjuna was a great devotee of Krishna. So basically, he was put into that kind of a situation by Krishna himself, such that Bhagavad Gita can be evolved. It is not that Arjuna was really in that kind of a situation. He has waged so many wars in the past also, and he has defeated single-handedly also. You know, in the Virata Parva, in that time also, all these Kauravas came, including Bhishma and all this. So he's defeated them. In one way, he's defeated, and then, so Arjuna is a capable, but Krishna has put him in that situation such that this Bhagavad Gita can come out. So, Sripad Ramanujacharya, not Ramanujacharya. I'm forgetting the name all of a sudden.
Sridhar Swami Prabhu.
Okay. So basically, in Gita Amrutam, the comparison is being given that the Krishna is like a coward boy, the Gomata who is there, it is compared with all the Vedas, and the calf which is coming near the cow, such that the initially when you ask the calf to go and suck some milk, it will take whatever milk it wants. After that, but the mother, the cow, will give the rest of the milk for our consumption, right? So similarly, it is compared to Bhagavad Gita to evolve. Arjuna has been used as a calf to bring this Gita Amruta, such that we can all enjoy and nourish ourselves in this material world. We are bewildered most of the time and we don't know which path to take. So all this can be taken care of when you get the right kind of a knowledge, and that's where Bhagavad Gita has been evolved. So that's what is the comparison. So Shankaracharya, I'm sorry, it was a very trivial thing, but I forgot. It was called Shankaracharya's Gita Amrutam, in which this was given. Okay.
Gita Mahatyam.
Gita Mahatyam. So Ravi Prabhu, I think to put it in a very nutshell, so basically Arjuna was really not bewildered. He was put into that situation such that this literature can come out. That is what it is. It's all Krishna's mercy and Krishna's leela that he can do anything. Right? Okay, so we'll go ahead with our things that we planned for today. So, as we discussed, we really wanted to have a right kind of a purpose in our life, and we wanted to have path which we can follow such that we can achieve our goals in our life. And for that, Krishna is given the knowledge of the soul and the body. And later on, he has told you need to perform two dharmas. And now in the next sloka, in the second chapter, 41st verse, he is going to tell you something more, right? Vyavasayatmika buddhir ekeha kurunandana bahushakahi anantascha buddhayo vyavasayinam. So here in this sloka, please use your Bhagavad Gita. If you have, please have it in your hand, because we wanted to read Bhagavad Gita and gain a lot of knowledge by reading it, not just by hearing only, but you also have to read. For that reason, I'm not doing a lot of presentation, PPTs kind of thing. But you can also follow me while I'm reading this. So here the translation says that those who are on the path, on this path, which path? The path what Krishna is given, those who are on this path are resolute in purpose. And their aim is one. Oh, beloved, the child of the Kurus, the intelligence of those who are irresolute is many branched. See, one should have faith. The faith is what is the preliminary qualification for you to progress in this spiritual path. Unless until you have faith, you cannot proceed. Right? See, we also have seen that the knowledge, the way we gain this knowledge is in the descending process we gain this knowledge. Not in the ascending, the way the modern methodology is. See, the modern methodology is that somebody proves something and later on after 2 years, he gets a Nobel Prize because he disproved the other person who also got a Nobel Prize. So, because that is how descending, that is the ascending way that they are gaining the knowledge. And which is, we have seen that because of our limited senses that we have, and we are prone to illusion and cheating propensity and committing mistakes. All these will say that whatever knowledge, if we put it from our end on our own or by somebody else who has given that to us, that is not the right approach. The approach is that it has to come from the Supreme Lord, who is crystal pure, and from there, in the descending order of the Guru Parampara, we have to get the knowledge. And we have also said that through Vedas are the basis for all the discussion that we are going to do, and we have to follow the Guru, Sadhu and Shastra, right? So as mentioned here in this particular sloka, a person who is intelligent will be resolute in his path, and he is not, and his faith is very strong, and it doesn't get shaken just like that. So that is what strong faith in Krishna consciousness is, the way one should be having, and how do we cultivate that faith is what is going to be discussed more in detail. So I'll tell you a small story, and it is from Bhagavatam. There was a cobbler and a Brahmana. So Narada came once, and he first initially met the Brahmana, and the Brahmana said, you keep going to Vaikuntha and other places. So when you go for some time, please ask the Lord, when will I get mukti? So liberation. Narada said, okay, sure, why not? I will ask him. And later on, he comes to the cobbler. Cobbler means a person who makes shoes, chappals, and things like that, leather ones. So he also poses the same question, saying that please go and ask when I will be getting mukti. So then Narada goes, and he goes and inquires about these two people. When will they get liberation? Then Mahavishnu says that the cobbler will get mukti in this lifetime only, but the Brahmana, it will take many more lives. He was surprised. Narada was surprised, saying that how is that this Brahmana is a person who has been doing deity worship, and he's been involved with spiritual activities a lot, and a cobbler, he does only making some chappal, shoes, things like that. So how is that? Then Narayana says that when these people ask, you can tell him that what I was doing is, I was sending an elephant through the needle hole. There is a needle, right? And the hole is there. And I was sending an elephant through that hole. So then you will get the answer why these people, one of them will get liberated in this Janma only. Then he goes and tells, and goes and asks a general inquiry. Then Brahmana inquires, did you ask about my liberation? He says that, Narada says that, this is what the Lord was doing. This Brahmana says that, how is it possible to send an elephant through a needle hole? It is not possible. You never went to Vaikuntha at all. You are just lying, and you are not even gone anywhere. And he is now more annoyed, and then leaves. When he comes to the cobbler, and the cobbler, when the same thing is told, that this is what Sri Mahavishnu was doing, then the cobbler says that, yes, he might have, Sri Mahavishnu might have sent the elephant through that hole already, because if the Lord can think about it, he can do anything. He can float the big planets on the air. What is not possible for him? And he can put a banyan tree in a small seed, and when it's sowed, the big banyan tree can come. What is not possible for the Supreme Lord? And what I'm trying to prove, and because of that faith, what he has on the Supreme Lord is what made him to go and take that liberation, right? So for us also in our life, faith makes a very important role or plays a very important role in our life also. So here in the purport also, Srila Prabhupada says that a strong faith that by Krishna consciousness one will be elevated to the highest perfection of life called vyavasayatmika, vyavasayatmika intelligence. So that is what we also will eventually gain when we start this pursuit in Krishna consciousness. Faith means Hare Krishna. So faith means go ahead, bro. So
very, very sorry, I interrupted.
No,
you should. So sorry.
The you have a question, Prabhu?
Vishnu, yeah, have an heart which I'm trying to access. Basically, beat a Vishnu Purusha, I mean, we are all
Prabhuji, your
so in that case,
Prabhuji, your signal is very low or the bandwidth is not okay. I don't know. There is a lot of blanks in between, not able to follow. So put it on the chat. In the end, we'll take these questions. Please don't mind. Okay. So the definition of faith is that faith means unflinching trust in something sublime. That's what is mentioned in the purport also. Faith means unflinching trust. The nearest that we can say is that a small baby will have a trust on the mother only. It doesn't have trust on anybody else, because that unflinching trust is what, which is sublime, is what is called faith. So that is what we have, it is mentioned in the purport also. The resolute purpose of a person in Krishna consciousness is based on knowledge. So once you have this knowledge, that knowledge of what? It's mentioned very clearly. Vasudeva sarvamiti sa mahatma sudurlabha. A person in Krishna consciousness is the rare good soul who knows perfectly that Vasudeva or Krishna is the root of all manifested causes. So if you have this kind of faith on Krishna, and that is what is the real faith. And this cobbler had that faith. So it is also mentioned many times that, and in fact in Chaitanya Charitamrita also it is mentioned that Rake Krishna Mare Kon, Mare Krishna Rake Kon. If Krishna decides to kill somebody or harm somebody, who can really protect him? And if Krishna decided that he should protect somebody, who is going to harm him? So Rake Krishna Mare Kon, Mare Krishna Rake Kon. So that is the unflinching faith one should have. And the difference between a devotee and a non-devotee is faith. And within the devotee community also, if you wanted to observe, if you wanted to say how good or how much he has progressed in his spiritual path is more to do with Shraddha, as somebody has said, or faith. Shraddha and faith are more or less synonymous. There is not an equivalent word to Shraddha in English, but the nearest is faith. So that is what one should really have. And how do we cultivate that is what is given in the subsequent purport itself. So how to develop that faith in the Supreme Lord? Because each one of us wanted to have that kind of a faith. Because how happy you will be, just imagine. I was also thinking myself that when I was a small kid, I was depending upon my parents. And for anything, I used to go to them. And when you are a small kid, like you hardly used to crawl sometimes at least. And in that kind of way, you are dependent so much on your mother. For your food also, you have to depend upon your mother to have her feed you. So that kind of a submission, that kind of a faith, when you have, you'll be really enjoying. So if you can also have that kind of a dependency on Krishna, on the Supreme Lord, just see how much you can enjoy. So that is the kind of enjoyment that these devotees always have. And now if you see the history of Srila Prabhupada, he has taken sannyas at the age of 50. And later on, when he was like around 60 plus, he went to US and through a he took a voyage on a cargo ship where 38 to 40 days he has to travel, and he had seasickness, he had two heart attacks. So, but he has that faith that Krishna will protect me. And Krishna, he written a very beautiful song in that he mentions that, Krishna, I am like a puppet. So if you ask me to dance, in whatever way you want me to dance, I will dance. So that kind of a faith is what he had in his guru and in Krishna. So that is what has really brought him wherever he is. Mataji sent during the session. Okay. Ah, that's good. Thank you, Prabhuji. So please put it in the chat so we can take it up. So there are so many instances. So now coming back to the question, how to develop this faith in the Supreme Lord? Can somebody put me on the chat? How do we develop this faith on the Supreme Lord? What do you think? How can you develop?
By chanting, Prabhuji.
Okay, one is chanting, you saying, yeah. What else? By surrendering, believing in the words of the scriptures, do as the cobbler did, loving Krishna unconditionally. Very nice. So, okay.
Trust Prabhuji, just like we leave everything with our parents, parents take care of us, we leave everything to the Supreme Lord so that he would definitely take care of us.
So, if you read the purport, Srila Prabhupada very logically he puts it, how to develop this faith in Supreme Lord, because we cannot directly approach the Supreme Lord. So we have to go through the Guru. So that is when you surrender to Guru and when you do whatever the Guru is instructing you to do, that is where the faith in the Supreme Lord will be established. You see, and it is very nicely mentioned here, Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur instructs us in the famous prayer for the spiritual master that we do every morning. First, we do this Mangal Arati. Yashya prasadat bhagavat prasado, yashya prasadat nagita kitopi, dhyayan stuvam yashasri sandhyam, vande guru shri charanarabindam. So here it is clearly mentioned that by satisfying the spiritual master, the supreme personality of Godhead becomes satisfied. So if you wanted to satisfy the Supreme Lord, you have to satisfy the Guru. And if you wanted to have cultivate faith and you wanted to have that faith on Krishna, on the Supreme Lord, you have to go through the process of surrendering to the spiritual master. And when you surrender to the spiritual master, do your as per his instructions and do the service to him. Because that is where you get that faith and trust, and you can get that love towards the Supreme Lord. So that's how, and our Gurukuls in the olden days used to have that. So in the Gurukuls, children, the students and disciples never used to pay anything the way we are paying now. There, they used to go and stay with the in the ashrama of the Guru, and they used to do service. And during the process of the service, the Guru used to teach them. And by surrendering, they used to learn. So there are so many examples where how disciples have surrendered to their Gurus. Now, you know that there is a famous, Ramanujachari had so many disciples. And and that time, it is like 1,000 years back I'm talking about. And that time, there was one devotee who was serving in the Tirukmara Devastanam there, and he was becoming old. And now Ramanujachari wanted to send somebody to take up that seva there. And the seva was specifically more to do with the flower seva. The floral seva that Lord is very much interested, or he wanted this flower seva, and he is very passionate, like he likes to get this seva done. So then he asks all his disciples if anybody can go to Tirumala and take up this service. And it is so happened that that time, 1,000 years back, what was the state of the Tirumala and Tirupati? It was a big jungle, and there you hardly anybody used to be there in the Tirumala. So, and now you are saying that somebody has to go and travel there on foot, and now go to Tirumala and stay there permanently and do this service. And do the service of having a small garden, flower garden, and also because if you wanted to get flowers from the town and getting it to Tirumala is very difficult. So the garden should be established. And he asked his disciples, and no disciple wanted to leave Ramanuja. And at the same time, taking that service is a Herculean task of going there and staying there alone. And that too, because so many wild animals, serpents and insects, and so much difficulties, right? So out of which person by name Anantachari, he accepts this service by understanding the guru's mind. And he says that, yes, I wanted to go. But when he wanted to go, his conditions, personal conditions was that he had a small kid and his wife was pregnant. And just imagine, how is that possible? And he has to go by walk and travel all the way and go to the Tirumala. And in the process also, he had so many difficulties. And finally, he reached there and he took up the service of the guru. And there are so much beautiful pastimes that have happened, wherein in short, he was, because the guru's mercy was there, he was able to do that service so well, and he was attached to that service. And at one point of time, he also challenged the Supreme Lord Sri Venkateshwara, saying that when Venkateshwara Swami was annoyed in one way, lovingly annoyed with him, then he questions back to Venkateshwara Swami, saying that, how can you tell me that you go from here? This is not your place. My guru has asked me to come here, and I am doing this service not because of you, but because of my guru I am doing this service. So if my guru says that get away, then I will go from this particular place, not just because you are telling me. Later on, that particular pastime is a very loving pastime. Basically, Lord was very happy to listen from Anantachari, how much affection he had, how much trust and faith he had on his guru. So much has happened between Anantachari and Lord Venkateshwara, wherein there was a small well that needed to be digged, and he was doing that service, and he doesn't want to take anybody's help, because that's a service that he was wanted to get involved. And his pregnant wife was there, and she also wanted to assist. But again, she was unable to do. And the Lord was very pitiful about the situation that he was in. And he has come as a small boy to help him, but he did not take that service. He was not allowed to give that service to him. But anyways, finally, he knew that this boy was getting involved with the service. And Anantachari was very not happy that somebody else is taking up this kind of service that I wanted to do. And he chases him, and he hits him with the rod, and it touches the chin of the boy, and he runs into the Garbhagudi. So later on, they see that the Lord Venkateshwara had a notch here, and that notch is still there, and they do they put, if you see Lord Venkateshwara, there is one they put one what is that one thing they put here, such that that mark is not visible. And Anantachari is a great devotee, and in one way later on also there are so many pastimes wherein Anantachari is considered that he is his father-in-law. There was this pastime story where they go to the garden and do a lot of things. But anyways, so what I was trying to bring in here is that all these devotees have so much faith on their guru, and they take their instructions as their life instructions. Now, if you see Srila Prabhupada, his Guru Maharaj, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he told to Srila Prabhupada that if you have money, print books. And you go to the foreign country, Western countries, and in English, you start doing preaching. Because that time, we are very close to that independence movement, etc. And we were following the whatever the Britishers were, or the Western people were following. So now when you give this knowledge to them and they, when they accept it, all the Indians as well, everybody in the world will accept it. And he has taken that instruction. These two instructions were the pillars for Srila Prabhupada and ISKCON. Printing books and preaching in the Western countries. And eventually that is what has been the reason for his success to establish ISKCON. Within 10 years of time, in a fly span, he has constructed 108 temples all over the world, and he has traveled all over the world 13, 14 times. And he had so many thousands of disciples he has initiated. He established ISKCON and GBC, etc. So faith on the guru is what one should have. And that is the preliminary thing that that will really give us faith on the Supreme Lord. And the Krishna consciousness is a process wherein that bhakti, if you need, you need to have that bhakti lata beach. The seed should be implanted, and that will come through that faith only. So that is what is, and also in the purport it is mentioned that the sense gratification manifested in fruitive activities, that one should really give up. And one who is not firmly fixed in the mind is diverted by various types of fruitive activities. So basically, we have seen in the previous class that there are karmis, jnanis, and yogis and bhaktas. These are the four types of people are there. And out of which karmis are basically doing activities, we're desiring something. Yes, Mataji. Camphor is applied on the Lord. Pachya Karpuram, they call it as Pachya Karpuram. That's what, I didn't get that word. They still put it on their on his chin. Okay, so basically these four kind of devotee classes of men are there. The karmis are always interested in, or they are desiring material desires, and they do activities because of that only, karmis. And jnanis are doing activities, but they do activities in the sense that they wanted to do certain things such that they can merge into the Supreme Lord, or in the effulgence of the Supreme Lord. So they wanted to get merged, but they don't believe that Supreme Lord has a personal form. So that way that they are bereft of that particular loving exchange that one will have with the Supreme Lord. So what will they do when they are staying there for after getting liberated also? They get bored and they come back again to this material world. So that is what these jnanis do. And the yogis, you know that they are only interested in some siddhis. They wanted to get this siddhi, that siddhi. Finally, again, it is all in the material domain only. What will you do? They do with if they can fly on the air or walk on the water, what is the use? And finally, bhaktas are the people, they do it for the loving, they serve the Lord. They love and serve the Lord. So that is what we all should aspire to become, bhaktas, right? So the next verse that we will be taking is for second chapter, 46 verse. Basically, in this verse, what is mentioned is that one who knows the purpose behind all these Vedas, those people will really understand what they wanted to do with their life. Because Vedas, when you see Vedas, or all the literature, most of the literature what you see is all related to rituals and sacrifices, called it as karmakandas division in the Vedic literature, and it is meant to encourage gradual development of self realization. But once you go and start doing this karmakandas, you are generally people get lost in doing that, and they do this karmakanda because they for material desire fulfillment only they are going to do. The purpose of studying the Vedas is to know the Supreme Lord Krishna. So, and who is the primeval cause of everything? Sarva karana karanam. So self-realization means understanding Krishna and one's eternal relationship with him. So the definition of self-realization is that understand who is Krishna and the eternal relationship of yourself with Krishna. When you can get that, that is what is self-realization. Yesterday we were reading this book called Science of Self-Realization. That is what Srila Prabhupada very nicely mentions that, right? And all the Vedanta, so we call it as Vedanta, means the last word of Vedic wisdom, whichever we say, that is Vedanta. And the last word is that Krishna is the Supreme Lord, and he is the cause of all causes, sarva karana karanam. So that is what Vedanta means. Okay, so we will go to the last 59th verse. I know I'm going little turby-turby kind of a thing. So we'll try to summarize in a proper way little later. So, second chapter, 59 sloka. Vishya vinivartante niraharasya dehinaha rasavarjam rasopya asya param drushtva nivartate. Here, it is mentioned that the embodied soul may be restricted from sense enjoyment through the taste for sense objects remains. But seizing such engagement by experiencing a higher taste, he is fixed in consciousness. So, what do you understand from this particular verse? Anybody can comment? What do you understand from this verse? The embodied soul may be restricted from sense enjoyment, though the taste of sense objects remains. But seizing such engagement by experiencing a higher taste, he is fixed in consciousness. Now, what is happening is that with all these people, so if you see, in Western society also, there are a lot of people who have come to a stage where they are presidents of some big nations and countries like US, and but they couldn't really control their senses, and they act in such a way that they do all nonsensical activities, or because of their lack of sense control, that they thought that they have conquered their senses. But again, there is a tinge of that particular taste for that sense object still remains. So because of that, they may fall back and commit the mistakes again. So that we have seen so many times. And in our Bhagavatam also, so many times and so many things have been told that if you see Vishwamitra Muni, he has done so much of tapas, and he was controlling everything, his senses and everything. But again, that tinge of the sense enjoyment is still there. Because of that, when Menaka came with just by hearing the ankle bells of Menaka, he just came out of his tapasya. He broke his tapasya, and he had relationship with Menaka, and again he realized that he made a mistake of not having the right kind of a sense control. But now if you see what has happened to him, so that tinge of material taste which was experienced by him is still there. Because of that, he fell down. And similarly, Shobari Muni, he was doing, he knew that in this material world there is a lot of disturbance. So he went under the water and he was doing tapas there. And finally, when he was doing tapas, he saw two fishes, a male and a female fishes mating. And he sensed enjoyment, whatever he had earlier, that came up and he broke his tapas. And again, he had to marry he married and again his tapas was broken. So what is that we are trying to learn from this is that when you try to suppress certain things, okay, and you think that this has gone out, and later on this will come back to you and you will indulge in the same activity again. So what is the solution for this is the question that we are trying to seek here, and this is what Krishna is trying to address here. Because we as devotees also, we may fall down. We may say that I am doing chanting, I am doing this. But basically why Krishna is saying is this, because you need to really take care of this particular thing. If not, fall down can happen. For any one of you also, this is possible. Right? So the example given is about Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur was called Namachari. Because he used to do chanting, and he had a very big position from material point of view also. He was at that time he was like a very important person in the government official position also. So what happened is that there were a lot of envious people, and they wanted to disturb him. And like in Vishwamitra's case, Indra sent this Menaka and disturbed him. Similarly, the Haridas Thakur also was becoming famous in one way because of his bhakti and other things. And there are a lot of envious people who wanted to disturb him. So they sent one very beautiful young prostitute in the night to disturb his sadhana and make him fall down. Later on, it is seen that Haridas Thakur made that young girl, woman who came to disturb him also as a disciple and a devotee. So that is what, and he never fell down. So that is the power of when you do chanting, when you follow the instructions of your guru and your faith on the guru, sadhu and shastra, you will never fall down. And the progress that you are making, wherein this tinge of whatever that material contamination is still there, that will get removed. As the fire, when you put in the fire, when fire is there, some of the things which are generally not burnable can also get burnt. So similarly, all these anarthas will go away when you can do your sadhana very well. That too, in taking the Lord's name, the chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Okay. So the one last sloka we'll take up today, or we can close for today if taking time, and we'll take more of question answers. Okay. Let me take one last question. Okay. So the one last sloka we'll take, which is 62 sloka of the chapter 2. ध्यायतो विषयां पुंसा संगस्तेषु पराजयम् प्रजायते संगा संजायते कामा कामा क्रोधो विजायते. So here in this sloka, while contemplating the objects of the senses, a person develops attachment from them, and from such attachment lust develops, and from lust anger arises. So there is a sequence of events that can happen, and it starts with objects of senses. When you contemplate on the objects of senses, basically you will get attached to that, and from that attachment lust will develop, and from lust anger arises. So we'll discuss that more in detail at later point of time. So I wanted to summarize what we discussed today. Today we have seen that an intelligent person will develop faith in the Supreme Lord, And that faith of developing the faith in the Supreme Lord is the way that you can really make progress in your spiritual life. And the difference between a devotee and a non-devotee is the faith factor. And within the devotee also, if you wanted to find out how much progress he made, it is basically the amount of faith he has. So there is also told in our Monday, in our native language, that if basically what it says is that without Lord's permission, a leaf also cannot move. So that is what, basically for everything, Krishna is the Supreme Lord and he is the Sarva Karana Karanam. So that kind of a faith, if one has to cultivate, he has to take the shelter of the Guru. And once you take the shelter of the Guru, by following the instructions of the Guru, not just for fashion, you are taken that he is my Guru and I got initiated. So that kind of thing will not really help you. When you follow the instructions of the Guru, and what is that, the instructions of the Guru is that to serve as per his instructions. That's what Srila Prabhupada, he's called Acharya because he has shown us with Acharana. So that is the difference between a mundane teacher and an Acharya. Acharya is the one who really shows by practicing in his personal life, and that we can take. So that is how it is. When you take the instructions of the Guru and take it as your mission and do that service to the Guru, and that in turn will go to the Supreme Lord as a service. That we have seen with an example of Anantacharya, the way he has taken up the service at Tirumala. And now also when you go there in Tirumala, you find that his quarters are there, well maintained. And the well, I think it is also the well that he has decked with his own hands is still there. And they do that ritual now also. Every once in a year, the Lord is taken to his quarters. Because Anantacharya is considered to be his father-in-law in one way. That because of the pastime that has happened. We'll discuss that some other time. And finally, we concluded saying that the senses are to be controlled. And the way that you can, you think that by negation, you can control your senses. But Krishna says that, no, it is not possible. That a tinge of that particular taste that you had experienced in the past, that will still be there. Unless until that is removed, there is a possibility that you can fall down. And in the Bhagavatam also, we have seen that Vishwamitra Muni has fallen down. Because of that, Shubhari Muni has also fallen down. And when you see in the recent past, Haridas Thakur was, the people have tried to disturb him in the similar way. But he couldn't fall because the faith he had in the his Guru and faith he had in the holy name, that has protected him. And each one of us also, when we take to this process of taking the shelter of a Guru and following his instructions, and his instructions is that we have to take the Lord's name, attentively chanting the holy name is what is the way that we can really get all the benefits that one will get in other yugas. So attentive chanting is what is the basis. So that is the reason why we request each one of you to take up this chanting process, which is recommended in this Kali Yuga. Harer Nama, Harer Nama, Harer Nama, Eva Kevalam. Kalau Naste, Naste, Gati Ranyada. So with that, I will end for today. If you have any questions, please. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Nala Prabhu. Yes. Any questions are there, Prabhu?
Yeah, there are a few questions which are on the chat. So first we...
Yes, Prabhu, go ahead.
Two questions, two from Ramesh Prabhuji and two from Lata Swami Mataji.
Read it out.
So the first question, one is, Shraddha is a big word, both Mayavadi and us, based on this. Today Shraddha is unconceivable. Why?
Shraddha is unconceivable. What do you mean Shraddha is unconceivable? Faith is unconceivable? Inconceivable? What
is it? I meant that I think nobody has a Shraddha, maybe. unless one has really understood the very word Shraddha itself. We see this word Shraddha everywhere, but like say a person who is in PhD knows what is Shraddha, but that word everyone hears.
So Prabhuji, so if you see, sometimes what happens is that we think that only when somebody has achieved certain things, then only he will have. If you see the example of a cobbler and the Brahmana example, very simple example, the cobbler has developed that faith, that Shraddha he has got towards the Supreme Lord, and he has got perfect understanding about, so that cultivation will not come in a overnight. It will take some time, and but as mentioned very clearly, how can you develop that first Shraddha, faith? Krishna very well answered that. He says that when you take the shelter of a guru and follow his instructions as given by him, then you will be able to get that faith. And that faith, when it is you take it more seriously and work on it, the instructions that the guru has given, then you will cultivate that faith, and faith will be developed.
Now, after my question was before you, these things
okay.
unfolded, so okay. automatically it was answered.
Okay, thank you, Prabhu. And each one of us should cultivate the Shraddha. And the first thing that work for your spiritual progress, one should happen is that having a faith. Faith on what? See, the faith on a preliminary faith of one should have, then only they can come into this spiritual path. So each one of you who are here, but have some preliminary faith. Unless until you had faith, you will not come to attend these classes. Right? That is the seed that somebody has sown in you. And that will take into a good shape down the line, when we follow the process as recommended by our gurus.
What somebody told me a few days back is that Shraddha is something which where you are going to fall from a cliff of belief, but you just keep, but there's no cliff over there. You just need to believe and go on blindly. Just go on.
Yeah. In one way, if you see our entire modern society also, they might kind of criticize us there that you people are having blind faith. Ask yourself, I come from an IIT background. I know that each and every modern establishment or modern theory, whichever we are talking about, is based on some assumptions. And some, so based on that only we are doing rest of the things. Right. So you have some faith on those assumptions and you proceed. So similarly, we also have some faith, and that faith is not per se blind faith. We follow we have faith on Guru, Sadhu and Shastra. And whatever is now, if it is now, I'll give you a classical example. Whenever you touch a stool, you are supposed to take bath or you need to cleanse yourself properly. But in Shastra, it is very much mentioned that the stool or the cow dung, when you do any puja, it is very auspicious and you do it with your hand. And it is auspicious. You don't have to take any bath like that. But because you have faith. Faith on what? Faith on Shastra. So similarly, one when they cultivate faith on the Shastra, Guru, Sadhu and Shastra, that is where our progress will happen. Cultivating that faith, and putting water, it is like you need to protect this faith also. There are people, Mayavadis, who will come and disturb you, saying that, hey, why are you going and attending these classes? They are brainwashing you and trying to put you wrong faith. And so you protect yourself initially. As a tree guard, we need to protect ourselves. And later on, this will really give you a lot of benefit. Okay, I think I've answered that, Prabhu. So, Harshavardhan,
The second question is Dr. Lata Swami Mataji. Krishna is supreme. He had power to stop the war of Kurukshetra, where many people are sacrificed. But why he did not stop, which turned the Dharmakshetra into blood pool?
Oh, okay.
Didn't stop.
Right. See, Krishna can do anything. At the same time, he wanted this war to happen. So, see, if he wants, he is there in each one of us, right? As a Paramatma, he is there. And he if he wanted to kill Duryodhana, he could have just given him a heart attack and he would have perished and war would have not happened. And in fact, war has happened just because of Duryodhana. Not even because of Dhritarashtra. Though Dhritarashtra was one of the reasons, but basically Dhritarashtra was controlled by his love towards his son, Duryodhana. He was, and whenever Vidura used to go and preach good things to Dhritarashtra used to get convinced. And but again, because of the love he had towards his son, has stopped him not to stop him. Because Duryodhana used to threaten him, saying that I will kill myself if you really ask me to do this way. So because of that also he did. Finally, Krishna did this war because he wanted to teach to this world that whatever he is doing, that is dharma. And rest of the things is not dharma. If he says this is what it is, it becomes dharma. You know that, right? There are so many occasions. See, the entire Kauravas were much more powerful all put together, and from military strategical point of view and warriors point of view, they were much more in a stronger position than Pandavas. But finally, how did Krishna really defeat them? The way Bhishma was killed, Dronacharya was killed, they were not done in a way that call it as religious or in the principled way. But Krishna has asked them to do it in that way, that becomes religious. So again, Krishna did all this because to establish dharma. And if Duryodhana kind of people were asked to continue, then what will happen? And to bring out that change, Krishna has made this happen. And see, sometimes we also have to take it this way. Waging a war and killing is nothing wrong. This is the doubt that Arjuna also had. Arjuna also had the same doubt that why am I really doing this war? What is the benefit? Whether when I kill all these people, then all my relatives will go away. What will I do with this entire empire? With whom I can enjoy? Then Krishna initially told that, hey, Arjuna, you are a fool. That you are talking like a learned man, but you are a fool. You are not this material body, you are a spirit soul. And those people who are got killed in the Kurukshetra war also, they got salvation. They got higher planets, they have gone. So that way they are not got any, they got benefited only. And what is there if the population is, it's all Krishna can make it happen or not happen, it's all in his hands. So,
Prabhuji, the second question is why Krishna had that many number of wives? Like he has 16,108 wives and so many children. Oh. So why he should be having so many wives and children?
Okay, so that's the classical question that a lot of people asked. Okay, so Krishna, so one thing that we should understand here, as a principal point of view, I'll tell, and later on I'll address that question. Whatever Krishna did, we are not supposed to do. One, that's a principle. Whatever Krishna did, we are not supposed to do. Whatever Krishna said, we need to do. So that's at a principle level, that is what one should keep in mind. Okay. Now, why did Krishna have so many 1008 Ranis or queens? See, all this goes back to say that queens have desired that they wanted to be with Krishna or as having that relationship. That is one thing. And also, if you see from a in that yuga specifically, Dwapar Yuga only. All these young queens, whosoever were there, they were kidnapped by one Rakshasa. And that Rakshasa, Krishna kills that Rakshasa. And these girls do not know what to do now, because they stayed with the Rakshasa for so many years. They were captive and they were there with him. And they cannot go back to their parents now. And in that kind of a situation, then Krishna agrees that I am going to marry each one of you. And you will not just be like any other normal. You will be a queen. That means you will get equal treatment as a queen, and you will have your own, palace, and you will have your own kids with me. And he had so many kids. So this is all Leela. And this is all Supreme Lord. As I told you, whatever Krishna does, we are not supposed to imitate or do that. Whatever Krishna told, we need to do that. Okay. And eventually, all this has happened because each and every soul, individual soul, have desired for it. And if you see, the Devaki and Vasudev, they desired that, Krishna, we wanted to have you as my child. And Yashoda Mata also is asked the same way. And we will discuss that the Kartik Mas was over, but Damodar Leela is a beautiful Leela. We can discuss, and the love of Yashoda. And there's these each and everything, whatever we see, is what Krishna's Leela. And he has done this because all these others have desired for that kind of thing. So for that reason only he married so many wives, and not for his sense gratification. He is the proprietor for all the senses. So he doesn't need any of the mundane kind of a thing, right? Okay, so next question.
Ramesh, you had a question which I will not be able to rephrase it. Can you ask the question? You said, is there an index guideline from Srila Prabhupada?
Okay, it is like could you read it out again?
Okay, fine. So you asked multiple questions in one question. Said, what about shlok between yog, anvayvadness, yogis lost in austerity?
Sorry, Sri Harsha Prabhu, if you don't understand, don't take that question. Go for the next. We will answer it offline.
That's the question. No more questions.
No more questions. Okay. So, the last question was from Dr. Lata. Prabhuji, my last question. I do have more faith and love towards Srila Prabhupada than Krishna. Is that wrong? No, absolutely not wrong. See, if you see, the question from Dr. Lata Swami Mataji is that I have more faith and love towards Srila Prabhupada than Krishna. Is that wrong? Anantachari is the right example. Anantachari had more book of faith and love towards his guru, Ramanujachari. And to the extent, and Krishna loves that kind of a devotee who has more faith on his guru than on him. Because if Krishna also says that in Bhagavad Gita also, we'll discuss that later. So if you have to come to me, you have to come through my devotees. That is what he says. And why all these leelas he does also is to say that, to promote these kind of devotees and give us as an example also. So having that is absolutely nothing wrong. And if you have faith in Srila Prabhupada, he will definitely take you and bring you closer to Krishna one day. And submitting yourself to Srila Prabhupada or your guru is nothing but you are submitting to Krishna indirectly. And that is the process in which we should go. And that is what Krishna is saying in this sloka, what we read today. If you have to establish or get that faith, you have to go through via process only. we do not have the eligibility to go directly approach Krishna. So that is the problem. Eligibility is not there. How can we go? So we have to go through Vaya process, and that too we have to go through Yashya Prasadat Bhagavat Prasado. It is clearly mentioned. If Guru is satisfied, Krishna is satisfied. So that's really good, Mataji. You are really on the right path, and I really greatly appreciate that you really have so much of faith on Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna.
Yeah, my coming back to my question, because of the previous question, I was able to get back to what I had thought. Mm-hmm. So basically, now here we are. I'm new to this ISKCON thing. Here Srila Prabhupada is the guru whom we follow. So Srila Prabhupada have any prepared any tool or a quick reference index? Index is like, okay, this is content, you know. Okay, this is the thing. Okay, what is the action? So because if we have a situation which is going to create a cause, and then we'll have an effect, and then we'll commit a sin. So that book will tell, okay, this is a sin. Okay, do this. Okay, I escape this sin.
Okay. So you're saying that, I get the point. You are saying that there must be a book where if I have to take a decision, I'm confused and whether to do this or this. Is there any ready reckoner kind of a thing where I go there and then see that and follow accordingly? Is there any a book like that? Is that your
question? Right. Because we are talking about being single-pointedness.
Right.
So then it should have a sure mechanism.
Okay. Got it, Prabhu. So let me answer that. There are two ways to answer this. One is that I'll tell you from a perspective of the Shastra. The Bhagavad Gita is per se not a instruction manual saying that do this, or don't do this. This kind of a thing is not Bhagavad Gita. One, right? It is this is a Nirnaya Shastra. This is not a Upadesha Shastra. Upadesha Shastra is instructions given wherein as you asked. Some kind of a thing, do this, and don't do this. That is Upadesha Shastra. This is Nirnaya Shastra. Okay. So Bhagavad Gita tells you or equips you to deal with things when this kind of situation comes. How can I use my intelligence? How can I use my mind? How can I use my senses such that I can make proper decisions in my life? So that is Nirnaya Shastra. Okay, so when you gain this knowledge, you can equip yourself and you can take decisions in your life, and you will be able to guide others also. And that means you cannot limit yourself to whatever, like in other literatures, especially if you take Bible or if you take Quran, they are set of instructions that they are given. So the commandments, whatever you call it as, are in the Quran also, there are some, you do this, you don't do this, you should eat this many times, you should pray this many times. That is how they are Upadesha Shastras in one way, instructions given. But Bhagavad Gita is not that. It is much more. And once you get yourself equipped with this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, you can really flourish in your knowledge, and you can make decisions and help others also, because it is not like just instructions. Okay, that's told about Bhagavad Gita. But there are other books in our Vaishnava philosophy. One is Nectar of Instructions, NOI, we call it as. In Nectar of Instructions, there are nine verses. In the nine verses, all the instructions, what you need to do, what we should not do, all those things are given in our Nectar of Instructions. Rupa Goswami has written that, and he is our, in our parampara, he is one of the prominent acharyas, and Rupa Goswami, and we follow that Nectar of Instructions. And there is one Nectar of Devotion also. So these two books are also very important books, which we should be doing after Bhagavad Gita is done. So that is as part of the Bhakti Shastri we do. So to, I presume I've answered that question, Prabhu. So we'll go ahead with, if no other answers, no other questions, then we'll end for today. Sriharsha Prabhu, is that okay?
Yeah, there are multiple questions are there, Prabhuji, but it is already 8:55.
Yes.
So yes. Shall we note down all these questions and probably we'll answer them in the later sessions?
Yes, can yes. We do that? Please let us do that. So
yes,
in our chat, since we are recording this in the chat also, it will be available. So we can take. So thank you very much for everyone for joining and asking and posing your questions. We will take up whatever we missed in the next session and we'll answer it accordingly. Nothing, whatever you ask is going to miss. We'll make note of it. Please raise your doubts, whatever you have after this class in the online link that we have provided, or you can send it to me as well or to any of our admins in the group. Sriharsha is one of our admins and Govardhan Prabhu is there and Sanda is also there. So any of us or me, any you can send the I also recommend you recommend or request you that please write summary of whatever you learned today. So that way you can really get benefit out of these classes. I know today I couldn't really phrase things in a proper way or summarize things in a proper way because of my limitation, but I'll try to improve it. Tomorrow we'll get it in a nice, better perspective. And tomorrow we'll end chapter 2 and conclude chapter 2 and go for chapter 3 if possible. If not, we'll end with a couple of verses, chapter 2. And we'll discuss about the characteristic of a person who is following the instructions of the guru, and also what does he really attain once he follows the instructions of the guru and follows the two dharmas, and what is he going to really eventually get. So that is what kind of a state he is going to get, and what kind of a characteristics really he will be that kind of a person is what we see. That is more to do with the Atma Rama stage. Atma Rama. So that is what we'll discuss in great detail and we'll close.
Prabhuji, a small thing. In between, going from 41 to 56 sloka. So in between, how do I, if at all I wish to sometimes?
No, you can read on your own, Prabhu, because these are 108 important slokas that we are taking. Because there are 700 slokas, but we are taking a fraction of that 108. And if you see, chapter 2 is a summary of the entire Gita. So the theme is what we wanted, and to cover the important message that wanted to be given, we have picked up these kind of important slokas from Bhagavad Gita. But you can read on your own, but at least start with reading whatever we are giving. And in addition to that, if you want to read other slokas, you have, that's well and good. Yeah, but if you read these slokas and the purport of the verses that we are trying to cover here, that will really give you the message. At least one level we can go, and later on we can repeat it at a greater detail, and we can go much faster covering most of the in more of the slokas.
With your help only we can.
Yeah, sure. We will not leave you, Prabhu. It is like that. Like once you come into ISKCON, neither you wanted to leave us or neither we wanted to leave you. So it will be a bondage. So we will definitely help you to pursue this matter, the subject matter, in much more greater detail at later point of time. But right now, for the syllabus wise, this is what we will justify doing 108 slokas perfectly and understand the essence of Bhagavad Gita and inculcate those things in our life. More importantly, it should not be a theoretical exercise, but there should be a practical exercise also, wherein it will really go in and you can get some transformation in your life, which each one of us are seeking, and we are also experiencing that we'll share with you. Okay, Prabhu?
Yes, Prabhu.
So we will end for today. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Ananta Koti Vaishnava Vrinda ki jai. See you tomorrow. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhuji, Sri Harsha Prabhu.
Thank you very much.
Thank you all the devotees. Thank you.